Let's get to know me, baby. Let's know me and me. Let's know me and me. Let's know me and me. Hello people of the internet, welcome back to my channel. As you can see, the background is different and I love the way it's illuminating me, you know. Today we are making a really chilled video of Get to Know Me Tag, as you have seen from the title. And yeah, I'm in an outdoor space and I'm using natural light. In case you see the light changing, please understand. And yeah, I just want to, you know, a chilled video, not so much dressed up. As you can see, I have no earrings. Hey, YouTubers with lies. I just forgot my earrings in the house. And here I am making an excuse for it. Okay, let's just get into the video. And I hope you enjoy. And let's know each other. Comment down below which of the questions you would love to answer. And yeah, subscribe. Please subscribe to this channel. Subscribe kindly. And like. Okay, how old are you? I am double 22 forever, 22 forever. What country are you from? I'm from Kenya. How tall are you? I have never known my exact height. I have never measured my height. I don't know how heights are measured. I can't even estimate, but if I'm being kind of realistic, I'll say between 4'8 and 5'3. Yeah, I'm pretty short, but I don't know, I'm just estimating so that at least I give you a clue of how tall I am. Okay, where did you grow up? I grew up in Kenya, in Vihiga County. It's one of the counties in Kenya, a pretty small county, and in a village called Hamisi. But most of my life was in a small town in Vihiga County called Majengo and Bale. So yeah, I grew up in Vihiga County in Kenya, in the village. I'm a village girl and I'm proud to say it. How many siblings do you have? I don't know how I should say this, but I have one twin sister. Yeah, so we are only the two of us from my mom, but from my dad we are six, so we are the last ones. Yeah. What did you study in uni? I'm still in uni, in my final year, but Corona is refusing to let me finish. But by God's grace, I'm studying Bachelor of Science, Botany and Zoology. It is pretty much plain biology. And yeah, I'm in my fourth year, in my last semester. Yeah. What's your favorite food? Girl, I eat everything and anything, pretty much anything. But I once had a favorite meal and was matoke. If you don't know what matoke is, it is bananas and mixed with potatoes. That is Irish potatoes or waru, the way us Kenyans call it. And mixed with meat. But then I changed and I transformed and I became bougie. Okay, that's a joke. I just changed over time, you know, people develop. You develop yourself, you know what you like more as you grow up. So I loved pasta, any kind of pasta, the spaghetti, macaroni, whatever, any type of pasta with vegetables. I will eat it pretty much every day. I love it. Because I feel like it's healthy, you know, just boiling it and you eat it like that, not so much fats, you just eat the calories that are part of the pasta. So yeah. Question number 8 is, what does a normal day look like for me right now in quarantine? My normal days looks like this. Let me just explain. During the day, pretty much of my day I sleep so much, but during the night I'm very active using internet. That is how I am right now because of quarantine, and I wake up around 10 a.m. 11 a.m. earliest, but I still wake up earlier, maybe eat, then I eat, that is breakfast or lunch because it is late already, and then I either write my notes, read something on the internet, research something, sleep, what I'm trying to say, most of my day during this time is just sleeping, and during the night I'm more active watching movies and doing that. But before quarantine, most of the day is schoolwork. I'm in school, studying, classes, all of that, and during the night, read, sleep. Yeah. Question number 9, what's your biggest fear? Not living my purpose. That's my biggest fear. And I also have a fear of death. I don't know why. And yeah, today's April 5th and I'm celebrating my mom's death anniversary. It's 15 years since she passed away. And I don't know how to think about it or feel about it because she died at a pretty young age of mine. I can't remember so much of what we spent together, what we experienced together. But yeah, I just kind of wish that she could have fought more for this life than just surrender to death. But whatever happened, happened, and everything happens for a reason, and a reason that I already know. Question number 10 is biggest pet peeve. A pet peeve is an annoying thing. I hate people who are so much talkative. To be specific, guys, men, have you ever, you know, you just with someone but they're talking much themselves, not giving you an opportunity to talk? I also, my biggest pet peeve is people who do not, bad listeners. Yeah, that's a pet peeve for me. And also, when I want to do something and I have an obstacle to do it. For example, when I want to film a video at a certain place or of a certain quality, but I do not have a best camera, that one is a pet peeve for me. It's annoying, but manageable. Whoo! Introvert or extrovert? Most of the part, I am an introvert, but I can be an extrovert with the people I'm used to, like family and close friends. But an introvert most of the part, 90% introvert. Craziest thing you have ever done? Oh my god, this year when my birthday fell between and a period where we had a school trip to Mombasa, I'll upload those videos soon. And it was our first day in Mombasa, and imagine, a craziest thing that I did was to ask my lecturer to sing me a happy birthday. But he did. He's sweet. It was nice. You know when you're excited, you do things that you don't even think you'll ever do when you're sober. Excitement is like alcohol on its own. Yeah, but he sang me a happy birthday and I was happy because he was the first person to sing me a happy birthday. And probably the last time a lecturer will ever sing for me a happy birthday. I was so happy, so happy. Okay, question number 13. Do you have a motto? Yes. Be your own cheerleader is my every time, every day motto. Just be your own cheerleader. I mean, why not? And any female role models, I'm sorry, I never have role models. I just look at myself, develop myself, instead of looking at someone and trying to be them and you forget yourself. So I pretty much do not have any role models. Question number 13, your biggest struggle you overcame. This year, the biggest struggle I overcame was in January when I lost more than 20 videos for my YouTube content creation. It was my worst month. I felt the worst, but I overcame it. Like, you see, I didn't give up. I'm still encouraged to film more videos. So yeah, it was the biggest struggle I overcame this year. But in my life, biggest struggle, none that I can think about right now. But I think it was the struggles of growing up with having little and not everything that you ever wanted. Question number 16 is, when did you give your life in Christ? I gave my life in Christ in my first year, in my second semester, that is 2017, 12th February. Yeah. And I'm proud to have done that, even though I didn't understand what I was doing. I'm looking at my book. Advice to your younger self. I will say, if you're younger, if you're a teenager, this one goes to all teenagers, please try to. Oh my god, I can't talk. Okay, try to stay single as much as you can, but go on dates and then self-develop yourself. So be open to know more people, but please stay single. Like, guard your heart. Even the Bible says that. Guard your heart. Guard your heart. Question number 18 is, are you a Christian? No, I'm a believer. I really hate it when people use the word Christian. Jesus never called us Christians. It was people who first called the disciples of Jesus Christians at Antioch. We all know that if you read the Bible and if you did CRE, in high school. Yeah, I don't like the word Christian. I just prefer being referred to as a believer. You know, period. Just like that. And question number 19. I'm so sad. I'm getting to the end of this video. But yeah, I hope you have known me better. Any hobbies? My hobbies are number one, taking videos like this for YouTube. That's why I can't even give up, because I enjoy what I'm doing, even when I see no growth or whatever. Taking videos, taking pictures, having nature walks. Yeah, in this quarantine, I think watching movies and being online, watching vlogs and watching people's lives are my hobbies right now. And the last question. Describe any attributes of your personality. One thing that I can say about me, I'm such a moody person. I can be happy one second, sad the next second, I'm excited the next second. Like, I'm so moody, and I don't like that part of me because it's so unpredictable, and people tend to look at me as someone too hard to associate with. But yeah, I'm just like that. I can't change it, and I love it because you can never predict how I'm gonna react, so you'll be careful when you're talking to me and in what you say. And so yeah, guys, that is the end of my video. I really hope you've enjoyed it. Sorry for any distractions that you've had, any noises in the background, and I hope you've learned a thing or two about me. And tell me in the comment section what you didn't think I would be. Yeah, tell me what sounded surprising to you about me, and anything you would love to know about me, just comment down below. And kindly subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video, just at this same place, and I get to know me tag a better, deeper one. It will be like a game. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. If you've gotten to this end, you're a real one, like a real one. And I wanted to give a shout out, but I can't remember. But thank you so much for the love in the last video. And yeah, bye.